Hi guys, my name is Saish and welcome to the 8-Bit Govan. In today's video, we're going to see the 5 things you can do to improve your overall television viewing experience. And we're starting right now. Alright, so first thing you want to do is get good speakers. No matter what brand your television is, no matter how good you think it sounds, you cannot compare the sound quality of a television to the sound quality of a designated audio system. You can use your portable Bluetooth speaker, you can use a 2-channel audio system, a 2.1 audio channel system, or even a soundbar with a subwoofer, whichever fits your budget, provided it is compatible with your TV. Which brings me to my second point, which is checking your input-output configuration of your television. So what I mean by checking your television's input and output configuration is basically making sure that the device you buy as an add-on for your television is supported by your television. For example, if you buy a soundbar which has an optical out or an HDMI ARC out, but your television does not support an HDMI ARC in or an optical in, you cannot connect your soundbar to your television. So you need to make sure that the device is compatible with your television. It happened with me, so I'm just sharing it out with you guys. Also, most of the television now come with a standard 2 HDMI ins. Now that is good in case you have just 2 devices which are going to be connected to your television, probably your DTH, your dish connection, and probably your console like your Xbox or your PlayStation, etc. But in case you have something more to connect, like probably 3 devices to connect, then you might need to consider something like this, which is an HDMI, it's not a splitter, it's like a switch. So it has like, 3 ins, 3 HDMI ins and 1 output, and with the click of a button, you can actually select which input you want. So you just use up 1 HDMI port on your television and you can connect 3 HDMI peripherals on this device. Plus you have 1 HDMI which is still free on your television. So that's a win-win situation. Alright, so the third thing which you can do is get yourself an Android streaming device. It would be an Android box, or it could be like a Google streaming device like Google Chromecast, or this is like a half ticket streaming device, whichever it is. Basically, if you have a non-smart TV, these devices convert your television into a smart TV. And you can stream your content from your phone directly to your television. You can watch YouTube, you can watch Netflix. You can now check your Facebook, you can check your Instagram, send those annoying tweets on the big screen, and you can view it and your friends and family can see you do all these things. Alongside this, it also really helps to stream your data wirelessly from your laptop, from your PC. If you have not watched my previous video wherein I showed how you can use a laptop to stream movies directly into your television via an Android box, you might want to check that out. So having an Android streaming device connected to your television really, really helps out and improves your overall television viewing experience. And the fourth thing here is the wall mount. Now, everyone, including myself, would love the television mounted to the wall because that's how it really looks nice, that's how it's meant to be. However, most of us don't realize that we don't have to go with the wall mount which came with the television. We don't need to go with the stock mount. We can go for different options. What I mean by this here is, if you look at the wall-mounted TV in my living room, it is the default mount which came with the television set. It cannot move. I cannot move the television down, and due to that, the wires and the cables, everything is really, really, messed up and it's visible. However, the television in my bedroom is mounted with a third-party mount which has like an arm which can move. I can move it to the left and right. I can hide the plugs, the electrical sockets, everything, so that I can route my cables and I can do a proper cable management, and that's how it's supposed to be. Before you even think of mounting the television on the wall, have a mental picture as to how you're going to route the wires and how you're going to place your speakers or your setup box, your consoles, etc., so that it looks really nice and tidy and clutter-free. And the fifth and the final point here is not sticking with the default configuration your television came with. What I mean by this is when your television, you switch on your television for the very first time, the color, the saturation, the brightness will be set to a particular level by default. And most people would not really change this because they would be just content with the way the television is looking. However, there are some presets which you might want to try first, like cinema, movies, sports, vivid brightness, all these default presets. You might want to try them one by one to see if you're really happy with how the color is looking or how the picture is looking. If you're not happy with that, you might want to take it up a notch and change individually the brightness, the color, the saturation, and see, play around with all these settings first and see if you are happy with how the TV, the picture quality is looking. The same holds true in case you're having a speaker connected to your television and you're using your DTH, your cable provider's setup box, wherein you need to make a few changes to make sure that you're getting the optimal audio quality and the optimal video quality. So there are a few things which you need to play around in your TV and your setup box setting to make sure you're getting the correct audio and video. So that's about it, guys. These were the five things I could think of to make your overall television viewing experience better. I hope you like this video. If you have any questions or comments, let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you like the videos I've been doing, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And it really, really helps. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you guys like this video. I will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Take care.